everyone, it's me Payal. Thank you so much for watching this video. So in this video I'll be showing you how to make a shadow box, but before that make sure you subscribe to Dress My Craft YouTube channel and press the bell icon. So first we're gonna make a base of shadow box. So for that here I am using my superhero me collection from Dress My Craft. It is a 12 by 12 paper pack and it's a 210 GSM. This papers has a 24 papers and a 12 different design. As you can see, all the designs are beautiful. This is a skyline and I'm going to make a shadow box from out of this beautiful paper. So yeah, let's begin. So first we're gonna make a base of the shadow box. So for the base here I'm going to use Dress My Craft multi-purpose scoring board, so which has this triangular thing and the scoring tool. In this shadow box we're gonna use two different size of box. So first we're gonna make 3x5 inch box. So for that we need 7x9 inch paper. So here is a 7x9 inch paper and I'm going to score it from 1 inch and 2 inch from every side, as you can see in a video. I'm also going to put all the material list in a description box, so check it out. After that I'm going to use Dress My Craft bone folder and I'm going to fold each and every scoring line with the bone folder, as you can see in the video. So now it's time to make a box. So for that here I'm going to make a slit on a corner of this paper, as you can see in a video. So I'm going to do the same thing for all these corners of this paper. And after that I'm going to use this sticky glue to stick the edges of this box. You just have to follow the video because it's very easy to make a box. You can also make your own shadow box with the help of these boxes. In this way my boxes are ready and you need total 4 of them. So I already created them and after that I'm going to make 2x4 inch box. So for that you need 6x8 inch paper and this is the same method to make a box. So for that you need to score at 1 inch and 2 inch from every side, as you can see in the video. And then you have to make a box with the same method. So first I'm going to slit in the corner of the paper and then I'm going to fold this paper to make a box. So my all the boxes are ready. Now it's time for the arrangement. So for the arrangement you just have to do try and error. I'm just trying to arrange all the boxes like this and figuring out like how it looks good, and it's up to you. You can arrange all the boxes according to your choice. So I'm going to arrange it like this. So first I'm going to stick all these boxes. So for that here I'm using a tacky glue to stick it like this. You can also use a tacky tape, but unfortunately I don't have a tacky tape right now with me, so that's why I'm using this tacky glue. And then you just have to press it for a few minutes like this. So in this way you can also stick your all the boxes to make your own shadow box. There are also wooden shadow box available in the market. So if you are using a ready-made base, then you just have to stick your all the papers on the top of the wooden base. But in this video I'm going to show you how to make a base of shadow box, so you don't need to buy that wooden one. You can create your own base. After sticking all the box together, make sure that it dries completely, and after that I'm going to use this black cardstock and I'm going to stick this black cardstock on a back side of the shadow box to give some more extra support. So here I'm going to use a tacky glue to stick this cardstock on a back side of my shadow box. So after that I'm going to do matting on the inside part of the boxes. So for that here I have already cut 3x5 inch paper and I'm going to stick it with the foam tape. Make sure that you stick each and every element with the foam tape. Foam tape is a must for the shadow box. So in this way, our base is ready. Now it's time for the decoration. So for the decoration here, I'm going to use Rest My Craft, my superhero motif sheet. You just have to fussy cut all these elements to decorate your shadow box. As you can see, I have already pre-cut some of them, and you don't need to buy other embellishment from outside. You just have to take this motif sheet and you can easily decorate your shadow box with all these cute elements. So as you can see, they have everything which match perfectly with the paper pack, and I'm also going to use for few photographs. So we're gonna mat our photo on the same paper pack. So first I'm going to use this Rest My Craft mini trimmer. Trust me, this is a very handy trimmer. I just love it. So first I'm going to cut the paper according to the size of my photo, and then I'm going to use this corner punch from a Rest My Craft. And then I'm going to stick my photo on a printed paper with the help of foam tape. In a shadow box, you have to stick everything with the foam tape. Okay, so now it's time for the decoration. Here I'm going to put a very soft music so you can enjoy all this process of decorating the shadow box. So in this way, our shadow box is ready. You can see it looks so beautiful. You can decorate your kids' room with this amazing shadow box. I hope you like it. And here I have something for you. This is a 3M command tab. You can find it out from Amazon. You can easily hang your shadow box with the help of this tab. And yeah, I hope you like it. Feel free to ask me your doubt and questions, and make sure that you like, share and subscribe. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye-bye.